suspension's crucial. Most people appreciate a bike that feels stable, but also there's a balance as it relates to how sensitive and active your suspension is. Often it's a trade-off between how stable the bike is and how active it is over bumps. For me, it's trying to strike the most ideal balance. Once you get a taste of like a really good feeling suspension, it's like you're always trying to chase that. We are in Phoenix, Arizona, and we're tuning production shocks for the Tallboy 5 and 5010 5. I think we're just looking for like a well-rounded shock tune that works everywhere. Santa Cruz just has supportive, nice, loamy corners. This is like the opposite, just like square edge rocks and sand. When it comes to testing trips, it's a lot of riding the same segment of trail over and over. You basically take a run, get your bike set up as good as you think you can, and then give feedback to the OE tuner. I guess my only like on-trail feedback would be that it felt like the bike struggled to react to quick inputs on the trail, as well as the last shock did. We try enough shocks with enough changes made to where we can draw some sort of conclusions with where we want to go in terms of the tune. I pretty firmly believe that the best kinematic feels good to everybody, and it really comes down to like the shock valving that creates like that last few percentage of the experience you're after.
I think he's one of the best in the world in terms of figuring out how a bike rides and providing feedback to people in engineering.
He is a human dyno.
Drop 5 PSI.
Non-preloaded compression.
Could be that bushing.
Presumably more beefy.
Small bump.
Trail junk. Of the lighter flavor with the LRL01.
We'll see what works well here and then bring it back to Santa Cruz. Hopefully have something that works well in both areas.
Kiran's a pretty young guy and he's worked here since 2009.
I got started here in kind of a roundabout way. My dad did the landscaping for Joe Graney, the now CEO of Santa Cruz. Joe hired me to please sweep up the shop floor a couple days a week. Having the opportunity to sweep the floors in the engineering group put me in a really good place to get noticed to advance in the company.
And now, Kiran's input on ride characteristics of new bikes through geometry and kinematics, shock tuning, that's kind of his spot. So he can go out and iterate on a bunch of different things, different shock tunes, different lengths, travel places where there's different types of terrain to test out all the variations.
It's my job to work with engineering to accurately represent what the product group wants in terms of ride quality. And then from there, it's really just following the bike throughout its cycle until it's ready to be mold cut for carbon, shock tuning done, and shipped out the door.
How would I describe Kiran? Man, if you haven't met him before, you're not gonna get a whole lot out of him. He's quiet. He's a dominant RC car driver. He was a really good go-kart driver. He's pretty phenomenal on a trail bike. He's one of the best riders I know.
Basically, I started racing as soon as I started riding. While I was racing, probably the highlight would be winning the US National Series in 2018. That was kind of something that I always wanted to do.
At that point, he kind of stopped his full-time racing and really started to focus on the development side.
Kiran's work ethic is pretty strong. He's one of those people that maybe cares a little too much and he throws himself 100% into whatever he's doing.
My job is a way for me to constructively deal with some of my perfectionist tendencies. I think the engineers for the most part would consider me to be a pain in the ass. Like I wanna ride a bike that's amazing and I want that to be our standard. I do get fired up about it past it just being a job. It's very much a personal thing because I want to ride that bike that feels the best.
Yeah. job? What's your title?
I don't know.
Do you have a business card?
I never got a business card.
I printed my own.
I don't know if Kiran's humble. I don't think he is necessarily humble. He might be quiet, but quiet and humble are two different things. So he might not go shouting it from the rooftops, but it doesn't mean that he doesn't believe he's really good at what he does. But I think the tenacity that he's got to figure some stuff out is a real asset.
I think it's super important to continue suspension development and try to make the bikes ride as good as they can suspension-wise. Riding used to be my ultimate passion and the dream that I was chasing through racing. And I guess lucky enough to be able to turn that into a job that I enjoy doing. And to me now it means work, but I do still really appreciate getting out on the weekends with no work obligations whatsoever and go out and explore some stuff. I think that's still really special to me.
Are there any quirks? Kieran's like 95% quirk, and I'm perfectly normal.